Welcome back. Miss Kara Motzinger is in with us again today, and she's got library news. So we were just talking, Kara, and you have something you want to make sure everybody understands about the fine free at the library.
That's right. At the library, we no longer charge late fees for items that are checked out that don't come back on time, but that doesn't mean that they're free and that you can keep them for all time. So those materials do need to be returned. It just means that if they're late, you won't have a fee that keeps accruing and getting larger. But after it's been renewed several times, and a lot of times that will happen automatically, books and materials get renewed. But then at a certain point, usually I think it's 42 days or 48 days, if that item has not come back, you will be charged the full amount of how much the item costs.
So they'll have to pay for the book so you can replace it. I mean, you have to have that in your inventory. So.
Yes.
Wow.
So it just means that for like a lot of busy and working families, if you miss the date that they're due, you get a lot of leeway because you don't have to worry about a bunch of late fees adding up on, you know, all the books that your fourth grader checked out because they were doing a report or something like that. So we're just trying to ease the stress of that late fees were kind of causing and preventing people from getting library cards.
Right.
So yeah, you know, it's still a wonderful thing to be fine free. And
oh, it is.
Yeah.
Things do happen, especially when you have kids. A lot of things happen. So yeah, but you have to remember though, you don't have forever to bring it back.
Right. We still want everybody to be responsible and have a good collection for everybody to enjoy.
That's great. Now, I was asked a question the other day, and this one is really important because there's several people that need to be able to come into the library. They were thinking they could not come in because of the COVID and CDC rules and stuff. How does the library work around all that and make it possible for people to come in the library? What are your all processes and procedures?
We have a lot of procedures that we've been following, and people should not be afraid to come in the library. We do have procedures in place like that when you come in the library, you should have a mask and you should be wearing it over your nose and mouth.
Right.
But as far as taking care of the books, whenever books are returned, we quarantine them for at least, I think, 24 hours.
Right.
And we put them on a cart. So whenever people are returning things and they bring them into the library, there's a special place that they're returned. And then the staff members take those and put them on a cart, and we pretty much leave them alone, don't touch them. And then 24 hours later, we clean them, we check them in, and then we put them back on the shelves. So it's usually like a day or two between when people return them and they actually get back on the shelves.
Right.
So those are the things that we do. Also, when people are in the library and using the library, if they are picking out books or afraid about touching them, you really shouldn't be. Any books that are picked up and touched can just be put on a cart, and we will clean those before we put them back. The CDC has done studies that have shown that unless a book is directly coughed all over and that there's actual, mucus getting on the book, that it's not likely to transfer to people through touch. But again, we're doing the best we can at cleaning all those items. And when people are touching things in the library, they're usually pretty conscientious about putting them on a cart for us to then clean and reshelve.
Well, that's easy. If you've got a specific cart sitting there just for that, they can look at all the books they want and read the inside cover.
Right.
See what the story's about. If they don't want that book, then they just lay it on that cart.
Absolutely.
Oh,
We have staff who are wonderful about asking the types of books that you like to read and helping you find suggestions and helping locate those books on the shelves.
And that kind of shortens down the number of books you'd be touching.
Right.
So, oh, wow.
It does.
So anybody... You guys, you need to go to the library. I know some people haven't gone because they didn't know all this. So
Right. Now,
that's great.
Yeah.
Now we're going to go outside. Mm-hmm. You were telling me about Nature Quest. What is that?
Nature Quest is wonderful. It is a brand new initiative of several different organizations here in Jefferson County and nearby counties. And it's really to help encourage and promote everyone getting outdoors. So in this time of social distancing, everyone's looking for things to do, but also it's great to have a break from the screens and technology.
Oh, yeah.
So Nature Quest is a great opportunity to do that. Oak Heritage Conservancy is kind of heading up Nature Quest. It's very much like the idea behind the Park Hop, to get people out and visiting places in nature. So Nature Quest is just going to be, every couple weeks they'll release new challenges. And so the first one is out, and it's about ponds. And so nature journaling is a bit like observing and exploring. And so there are prompts on the first pond Nature Quest sheet that encourage people to answer just some basic questions about their surroundings if they visit a park or somewhere where there is a pond. And so when you answer those questions, you're getting out in nature, you're having fun, your kids are learning things. And it's free, it doesn't cost anything. So we're really encouraging everyone to take part in this. If you do the challenges, there are gonna be 8 between now and the end of the year. So every 2 weeks, there'll probably be a new challenge. And you can find out more about Nature Quest by going to oakheritageconservancy.org/nature-quest. And so the first challenge is up, and you can print those off. We'll have them printed at the library as well if you wanna come in and get them. And we're really excited about that.
Oh, that sounds like something new. And that's great for the kids. It expands their imagination and their thought process.
Right. And we have such wonderful resources here. We have wetlands. We have the down by the river. There's a lot of parks. There's Clifty. We're so fortunate to live in an area where we have wonderful recreation spots.
So now in the month of October, you've got what's called grab-and-go crafts. What is that? How do you grab-and-go a craft?
Well, we plan the crafts ahead of time, and all kinds of fun things for all ages of kids. And they're all in our Evance calendar, which is on our library website. So they start on Tuesdays, and people can, if you sign up, you can pick up anytime between Tuesday and Friday or Tuesday and Saturday. So we realize that since our hours are different and people have busy lives, we're giving people extra time to pick those up whenever they can get to the library.
Oh, wow. So. I was going grab and go crafts. How are we going
to? But they're fun. They're and they're usually things that kids can do with all the materials that are in the bag. We kind of put everything together. Every once in a while, you might need tape or some glue. But we have some really fun things in October. There's a bat. There's a fall windsock. There's a spinning disc that, you know, has the string. And you can decorate that. So there's some really fun crafts.
Oh, well, I think some of the adults are going to like that too, not just the kids.
Sure.
So, and then you have something you haven't been doing this summer because of the COVID.
Right.
And you're going to start story time again?
We are. We're starting story time again. We're really excited about it. It will not be in person. We're still not quite ready for that step yet. But we'll be doing a recording of story time. It'll be short. It'll be probably somewhere between 10 and 15 minutes. And we're going to air those on Wednesdays in October on our Facebook page. And so that's what we're doing. It's for all ages. It'll be rhymes, songs, and a story. And so we're really excited about those. And people can watch them starting on Wednesdays. But anytime after that, you can click on the link and view a story time.
Oh, good. That's great. Now, you're going to do something that's a little different this year with pets. What are you doing with the pets this year?
Pets. Okay, we're doing a pet parade. So we have done a pet parade a couple years ago in the summertime. We did a pet parade. It's just a really fun opportunity for families to come with their pets. And this year, since we're doing it in October, we thought we're going to try and do it socially distanced. So we really do want people to still wear a mask, even though we're going to be outside during the parade. And we'll meet in front of the library on October 24th at 1:00 in the afternoon. And we'll kind of meet there, and then we'll parade to the Broadway fountain. And we'll take one lap around the fountain. We'll probably pause and talk about our pets a little bit and get to know each other. And then we'll walk back to the library. So, I mean, it'll be short, but it'll be really fun. And we always love to see animals. pets will have to be on a leash. Doesn't have to be just dogs or cats. I mean, we welcome any kind of animal as long as they're supervised. And so we're really looking forward to that. And you can dress up. So costumes are optional. If you want to dress up your pet, if you want to dress up with your pet, we're really excited about that. And it's on a Saturday.
And that's a Halloween thing.
Sort of, yeah. I mean,
unless
it's just,
they want to do something different, but
yeah. So yeah, pet parade.
We'll have to watch for that.
Right.
That'll be cool. Now, my favorite part of October that you're going to be doing mm-hmm. is you're going to be decorating pumpkins, but there's a contest that goes with that. What is that contest?
That's right. It's a pumpkin decorating contest. So it doesn't have to be like carved pumpkins, but if you want to carve a pumpkin, you can. You can decorate them with any kind of craft materials. You can paint the pumpkin, and we'll have different categories for adult and kids, adult and youth. And so there's rules on our there will be rules on our calendar about the pumpkin decorating contest. But we're gonna, on Wednesday, October 28th, everybody can come from when we open the library at 10 o'clock until 6:30, we close at 7, and drop off pumpkins. So your entries can be dropped off. It doesn't cost anything to enter the contest. And then on Thursday, we will take photos of all of the entries, and we're going to put them in an album on Facebook so that people can vote for people's choice of their favorite pumpkins. And then on Friday the 30th, we'll announce who all the winners are. So we'll have first, second, and third place for adults, first, second, and third for kids. And the prizes will be gift cards to local places. And the first place gift card, I believe, is going to be for like a Visa gift card. And then the other ones will be for local places here in town. So we're really excited about that. And we're hoping we'll see a lot of creative pumpkins. And so, yeah, we're excited. We think it'll be a lot of fun. And we want to get everybody involved of all ages. So we're really excited, too, about the voting and the pictures. And I think we'll get some really cool pumpkins.
I think so, too. There's a lot of artists here in town.
Yes, there are.
I'm thinking, wow, what are they going to come up with? You mm-hmm. know? And I know some kids that are pretty creative. So
absolutely. So
that's really cool.
Yeah.
Was there anything else we need to make sure they know about the month of October?
You know, we have lots of wonderful things at the library that I feel like people don't realize we have. Not just books, we have online resources, we have a lot of, there's digital movie, or there's digital books, e-books, there's audio books. We also have Hoopla, and Hoopla is great because you can stream TV, TV shows, movies. So if you're trying to save money or looking for things to do at home, having a library card where you can download things with your Hoopla account is wonderful. It's been a lifesaver for a lot of people. So yeah, we have lots of really great things. We also have video games. We have tablets that you can check out. The tablets you can check out are mostly for kids, but we even have ones for older kids, and they're not connected to the internet. So you don't have to worry about connection and all that stuff, and they have fun learning games on them.
Well, I didn't know a couple of those things myself, so
yeah.
That's great. Then we need to do a little more information about the library when we do these, so.
Yeah.
Keep telling them what's there.
Right. Absolutely.
We can always keep doing that. Well, we greatly appreciate Kara coming in and sharing all this information with us, and we thank our sponsors for making all of this possible, and you for watching.